ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
नान्यत्र मद्भगवता
नान्यत्र मद्भगवता
प्रधान पुरुषेश्वरा
प्रधान पुरुषेश्वरा
आत्मनः सर्वभूतानां
आत्मनः सर्वभूतानां
भयंति ब्रह्म निवर्तते
भयंति ब्रह्म निवर्तते।
नान्यत्र मद्भगवता
नान्यत्र मद्भगवता
प्रधान पुरुषेश्वरा
प्रधान पुरुषेश्वरा
आत्मनः सर्वभूतानां
आत्मनः सर्वभूतानां
भयंति ब्रह्म निवर्तते
भयंति ब्रह्म निवर्तते।
Taken by anyone who resorts to any shelter other than myself. For I am the Almighty Lord, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the original source of all creation, and also the Supreme Soul of all souls.
Nanatratmadhavata Pradhana Purushi Sarat आत्मना सर्वभूतानां भयं तीव्रं निवर्तते। भयं तीव्रं, वी हैव बिकम सो मच डल और फूलिश दैट वी डू नॉट नो व्हाट इज भयं तीव्रं। Tibrang means very fierce and bhayam, fierce, fearfulness, very strong. And we are entangled in this very strong fearfulness, but we have become so dull by the spell of Maya that we don't care for it. Just imagine, at the time of death, there are so many troubles, very fearful. Sometimes a person is dying, is attacked with coma, and he's lying unconscious, big politicians, Mr. Such and Such, Prime Minister and this and that, but he's lying unconscious in coma for 7 days. And we do not know, but he's going very fearful test. He's dreaming so many things that sometimes he's crying, he cannot express. Especially those who are very sinful, they die in that way. So this is not finished. Then after death you have to enter in the womb of the mother. That is another fearful stage. You become packed up in a bag and the bag is filled up or surrounded by stool, urine, worms, and you have to remain there, airtight packed, for 10 months. This is actual fact. We have forgotten. Therefore you are not afraid of. Therefore Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita that your real trouble is janma mrityu jara vyadhi dukkha doshan darshanam. You have to accept your birth within the womb of your mother in a packed up condition, body developing, the germs, the worms within the urine, stool, biting, very delicate skin. You cannot make any adjustment, simply moving. And if one is little pious, he can pray to God, please get me relieved from this condition. Now I shall worship you. This is stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam. This consciousness. There is consciousness. After 7 months, there is consciousness. Then, somehow or other, you get out of the womb of your mother. Then there are so many troubles, crying. The child is crying, and almost dependent on mother's mercy. The mother sometimes cannot understand what the child wants. Some ant is biting, and mother is thinking that she is hungry, but actually it is not hungry. It cannot say that one ant is biting on my back, and he is crying. There are worms, there are mosquitoes, and there are bugs, and lying in the stool, in urine, cannot say. So these things we have to pass. And again, disease, again old age, and again death, and again birth. This is bhayang tibram. But we have become, by the spell of maya, by illusion, we are thinking, now we are making very much progress. What progress you have made? Have you stopped birth, death, old age and disease? These troubles are awaiting. Janma mrityujarabhyadi dukkha dushanadasa. You should always think that I am waiting for the miserable condition. It is already miserable condition. Even in living time, there are threefold misery. Even you sit down peacefully, then the mosquito will bite you, bugs will bite you, and you'll get some letter from some enemy. So even if you cannot sit down peacefully, if you think, I am sitting at my home very peacefully, so many things will disturb you, one after another. That is called tibram, bhayam tibram. But you are so bold that you are not afraid. There is foolishness. If we become over bold, don't care for this thing, that is foolishness. Mura. Therefore they are called muras. He is awaiting so many troubles in birth, death, old age and disease. Therefore the atheist class, they want to forget this. They think that there is no life after death. Just like I have given several times the example, the rabbit, when there is some enemy, it will immediately kill him, and he closes the eyes so that there is no enemy. So similarly, we have become so foolish about this birth, cycle of birth and death, and we do not ever think that how to get out of this birth and death and threefold misery of this material world. That means the whole subject matter of suffering is this material body. Because we are accepting this body, therefore there are so many troubles. Therefore the solution is how to stop this acceptance of material body again and again. That is intelligence. That you cannot get by material adjustment, by your so-called scientific education, advancement of civilization. It is not possible. Therefore here it is said, nannatra mad bhagavata pradhana purusheshara. Without coming under my shelter, there is no possibility. There is no person. Therefore, Krishna, out of compassion, he comes when we completely become dull and rascal. We forget the sufferings of this material life and we think that we are very nicely situated. I have got so much bank balance and I will live very happily. I have got so nice wife and so many children. Now my problem is solved. No, sir, real problem is not solved. Real problem is not solved. This temporary, you may have some facilities. This is called maya. Maya apurito jnana. The real business of human life is to, as we have several times discussed, is to discuss about the problems of life and inquire about the Brahma. Athata Brahma Jigyasa. That is real business of life. But we are not interested. Mudha. We are thinking that we are very happy. Now things will go on like this. I will never die. Sheshasthitamichanti kimasajamataparam. Yudhishthira Maharaj was asked by Dharmaraj, what is the most wonderful thing in this world? He replied, this is the most wonderful thing. What is that? Now, ahannahani go lokani gacchanti jama mandiram sheshasthitamichanti kimasajamataparam. Every minute, every second, they are going to Jamaraj and dying. But those who are living, they are thinking, this death will not happen to me. He is simply dying. My friend is dying, my father is dying, that's all right. But I am eternal, I will not die. He thinks like that. Otherwise you should have been prepared. Why you have to die? Then what is there after death? So the atheist class, they try to forget that after death there is no life. This is atheism. There is life, sir. Krishna says, tatha dehantara prapti. How we can say there is no life? There is life. But you do not know. Krishna says that after this human life, he does not say that you get such and such life. He simply says, tatha dehantara prapti, he'll get another body. Now, he does not say what kind of body. The question should be, all right, then what kind of body I'm going to get? That depends on your work. You can see in your front, there are so many dogs, they are barking, they are night, they have no food, they have no shelter. And anyone sees, he beats him with a stick or some stone, and there is no shelter, no food. You can get a life like that also. You can get a life like a tree standing before you for 500 years. Or you can get a life even like a demigod, if you are pious. So that will depend on your karma. Karmana devanatrena deha jantar deha upapatti. That will depend. Prakite kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasa karanam gunasangasya sadasat janma juni. Everything is there in the shastra. You can get a nice body or you can get a very bad body, not comfortable, cats and dogs body. But in every body, the living entity thinks that he is very happy. This is called illusion. In any body, any kind, either in cat's body or dog's body or tree's body or ant's body or Brahma's body or demigod's body or human body, he thinks, I am very happy. This is called prakhyamatmika shakti. Sometimes Indra became a hog being cursed by Brihaspati. So Brahma, after some time, came to receive him, saying, Indra, now you have suffered very much. Now come with me to your heavenly kingdom. He said, where shall I go? In the heaven. No. I have got my family, I have got my children. How can I go? The hog is thinking that he has got family, he has got his children, so he cannot give up this responsibility and go to heaven. No. It is not possible. So this is called Maya. Even in hog's life, dog's life, germ's life, stool's life, everyone is thinking, I am very happy. But he does not know that there is tibrang bhayam, very fearful condition. But he forgets. But one who is actually wise, intelligent, he can understand that actually I am not happy, I am suffering. That is intelligence. That is intelligence. When one comes to the understanding that I am not happy, actually I am simply suffering. The Sanatana Goswami, he was the finance minister in the government of Nawab Hussain Shah. So he is our guru in the disciple succession. He inquired this question from Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that I have come to you to ask that people call me, I am very learned man. Gramma babahare korohe pandit. By this ordinary relationship, they call me, I am very learned man. But I am such a learned man that I do not know what I am, why I am suffering. This is intelligence. So, we should know how to atanting dukkha nirvritti. Everyone is suffering. Temporary, superficially, one may think that he is very happy, or I may think that he is happy, I am not happy. But nobody is happy in this material world because the four things is inevitable for everyone. The prime minister or the man in the street, everyone. Janma mrityu jarabhyadhi dukkha dosanu darshanam. And there is so much trouble in the matter of birth and death and old age and disease. We are forgetting. That is called tibram bhayam. So, if one is intelligent enough, he would understand by association of sadhus that this material life is not happy at all. But we want happiness. That is a fact. Every one of us, we are searching after happiness. Atantik dukkha nirvritti. Dukkha means unhappiness and nirvritti means decreasing or completely avoiding. But that is not possible. Everyone, this morning I was talking that everyone who have come on this beach just to mitigate some trouble. So many people are exercising, throwing the hand, throwing the leg or something. But because there is some trouble, not that because they have come in car, very rich man, but still he is throwing his hands and legs and something like that. So we have to study like that. We should be intelligent that there is nobody happy in this material body. Nobody happy in this material, but by the illusion of Maya, he is thinking, I am happy. That is called Maya. Atakriyat-cetra-sutapta-vittai janasya-mohoyam ahamameti. By foolishness, being misspelled by Maya, he is thinking that I have got my home, very nice home, griha. I have got my property, griha-cetra. Atakriyat-cetra-suto, I have got very nice children, sons and daughters, atakriyat-cetra-suta, apta, I have got my relatives, my friends, so nice. And withdraw so much bank balance, so much money, then I am the most happy man. But this is moho. Janasya mohoyam. This is illusion. This illusion, why? He is forgetting the real business of his life. Entrapped by this so-called happiness. Griyachetra sutaka vittri. Therefore last, in the last verse, last line, it is discussed. Visidya sarvan annangs mamevang visyatomukham bhajanti ananaya bhaktya tanamitta udiparaye. So we have to give up this. Give up this means not that you have to become a sannyasi or give up your, but you must know your position. At least you must understand. You don't foolishly accept that you are very happy. Don't be fool. Be intelligent. That is shastra. The shastra means a person goes to school, college to become intelligent. Therefore, there are so many shastras, Vedas. Why Vedic literatures are there? To make us intelligent. Krishna bhuliya jeev, anadi bahirmukh jeev Krishna bhuli gela, atayev Krishna ved purana kurila. We are so foolish, rascals, that we have forgotten. We are suffering every moment. And still we are thinking we are very happy. Therefore, it is our misfortune that human life is meant for understanding what is the position of my life, why I am suffering. So, for that understanding, Krishna has given us so many Vedic literature. Four Vedas and the Puranas and the Upanishad and Vedanta Sutra, Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, Ramayana, Mahabharata. We have got enough source of knowledge, treasure house of knowledge. But we are reluctant. We are busy with the newspaper. We have got time to waste our time to read the newspaper, bunch of newspaper. But we have no time to read Bhagavad Gita or Srimad Bhagavatam or Vedanta Sutra, the books of actual knowledge. This is our misfortune. One has to visidya, as it is said by Kapil Dev, visidya sarvan anyangsa mamiva visyato bhajanti ananaya. We have to forget all these so-called sources of happiness. This is misleading. Maya. So who can understand that this is illusion, maya. Mameva ja prapadyante maya metang tarante. When one becomes a devotee, then he can understand that the position which I am now taking for granted, that it is very happy, that is mistake, that is maya. Krishna says that it is dukkhalayam asasatam. Krishna says, how you can take it as a very nice place? Krishna says, the Supreme Authority says, dukkhalayam, it is the place of suffering. And that is the fact. We are simply suffering on account of this body. We are simply suffering. Therefore, our main business is how to stop the cycle of birth and death, no more accepting the body. That is answered here, as Kapil Dev said, na annatra madh bhagavato pradhana purusa para. You cannot get it without taking shelter at my lotus feet. You cannot get out of this fear. Nannatra madh bhagavato pradhana puruse sarat ātmana sarva-bhūtānāṁ bhayaṁ tībraṁ nivattati. Tībraṁ bhayaṁ. What you are accepting spelled by Maya as very position, good position. I have told you many times, it is published in now. Therefore, the rascal class of men, they want to, they do not want to accept that there is life after this. Everything is finished. Therefore, in Western countries, there is killing, even grown-up child within the womb. They're killing, abortion. They think there is no life. Unless it comes out of the womb, there is no life. It's all nonsense theory. All nonsense theory. Simply commenting sinful life one after another and becoming entangled, the result will be that he will have to enter again into the womb of mother and he will be killed. He will be killed not once, he will be killed again when he enters the womb of the mother, again he will be killed. So many, many years he will not be allowed to see the light of the sun. Therefore, namang duskitunam murha prapadyante naradhama. People are becoming so naradham, so sinful and murha, that there is no rescue unless one takes to Krishna consciousness. There is no rescue. The whole world is going just like the flies. When there is fire, open fire, they come from long distance and phat. Being captivated by the beauty of the fire, similarly, this whole civilization, the so-called civilization, human civilization, is falling in the fire of illusory maya, phat. And again, bhutta praliyate. One takes birth, one again dies, again suffers, but we have no brain, murha, that's what it's called, murha. Namanga duskitunam murha, prapadyante naradhama. Therefore Krishna is so kind, and his devotees are so kind, that Krishna comes, jada jada hi dhanma saglani bhavati bharata. He comes. He is very unhappy by seeing our unhappiness in this material world. Because we are sons of Krishna. Mami vāṅsa jīva bhuta sarva joni shukavante asambhavanti mūteya tada sāṅg mahajjani brahma ahaṅga bīja padup. He is the father. So as father is very unhappy seeing the unhappy condition of the sons, although the son does not know. But father is unhappy. So Krishna is unhappy, therefore he comes. He canvasses. Like, why you are captivated by this false so-called happiness? You give up this, sarva dharmān parityajya māmekam saraṇam braja. I will give you relief. You come to me. You will live happily, eternally, blissful life without any, scarcity or without any trouble. The Krishna's business, he has no business to come here because his agent, Prakriti, is doing everything. But still, out of compassion, he comes in his original form, Krishna, or in his incarnation as Kapila, and he says the same thing. My dear sons, my dear rascal sons, you are suffering so much on account of this material contact. Please come to me, take shelter of me, and you will be happy. This is going on. And Krishna's representative says the same thing. That you rascal, you take shelter of Krishna and be happy. This is Krishna consciousness. We are going from door to door of all rascals. I tell it, declare it publicly. Anyone who is not Krishna conscious, he is rascal number one. I declare it. Come any intelligent man, I shall talk with him, I shall prove that he is rascal number one, if he has no Krishna consciousness. That's a fact. So, this Krishna consciousness movement is meant for the rascal number one, and we always canvassing, soliciting, please take to this, not that we have invented someone. As Krishna said to Arjuna, that this philosophy, this Krishna consciousness philosophy, imam vivasati yugam prattavanaham abhyam vivasan mano viprahu manu ikha kavibhu. I explain this philosophy of Krishna consciousness many, many millions of years ago to the sun god. When he says, imam vivasati yugam prattavan aham ambam, vivasa, the name of the sun god at the present moment, his name is vivasa. People do not know what is the sun planet. But we know the president of the sun planet, his name is vivasa. How do you know? We understand from Krishna. Therefore our knowledge is perfect. You can say, have you gone to the sun planet? No, there is no need of going there. Here is the authority. Krishna says, so we accept it, that's all. Our business is finished. Krishna is perfect. Whatever he says, it is perfect. Therefore, I am not perfect, that's a fact. But because I am speaking of the words coming from the perfect, that will be perfect. It is not speculation. It is very easy for us because we accept the words of the perfect. Therefore, whatever we say, it is perfect. You challenge me, are you perfect? I am not perfect because I am not speaking my words. I am speaking the words of the perfect. Therefore, whatever I speak, it is perfect. So, this knowledge, Krishna is canvassing. He comes there. Occasionally, he comes once in the day of Brahma, and the Brahma's day is explained in the Bhagavad Gita, Sahasra Yugapadjantam Arahajat Brahmano Vidhu. It means 43 lakhs of years, add 3 zeros, some crores of years after Krishna comes once in Brahma's days. Jada jadahi, that is just like the sun rises early in the morning, say after 12 hours. Similarly, Krishna's coming here, there is calculation in the Shastra. He comes once in a day of Brahma, means some crores of years after he comes. So things deteriorate. And not only he comes as Krishna, he comes at a certain period, and still his incarnations also come to educate these foolish people who are thinking that we are living very happily, to canvass them, to say the same thing. Similarly, Kapil Dev also, he is propounding the Sankhya philosophy. This is Sankhya philosophy. What Kapil Dev is saying, Sankhya philosophy means unalloyed devotion to the Lord. That is Sankhya philosophy. There is another Sankhya philosophy. He also imitated the name of Kapila. But he is atheist Sankhya philosophy. But here we should remember Sankhya philosophy originally propounded by Kapil Dev, the son of Devahuti. Kapil Dev, the son of Devahuti, explained to his mother. The mother wanted to know from the son. His father left home and the mother was kept at the care of his son, grown-up son. That is Vedic system, that when the son is grown up, the mother should be left at the care of the grown-up son, and the father should take leave. He should become vanaprastha sannyas, no more connection with wife. This is Vedic system. So, Kapildev's father, Kardam Muni, he left home and he kept his wife under the care of Kapildev, and he is propounding this Sankha philosophy. And today's verse is, na anatra mad bhagavato. Without him, without taking shelter of Bhagavata, Bhagavan, Bhagavan means Hari Sajya Purna, with Almighty Lord, nobody can give you protection. Just like when one is condemned to death by the justice, though there is no other way to save him than by the mercy of the king or the president, he can save. Similarly, we are all condemned. We are suffering this material condition of life, constantly chained our body and suffering the threefold miseries, tibrang bhayam. This is very fearful, but we do not understand. We are living in such condition, but by the spell of maya, we are thinking we are very happy, but that is not actual fact. It is tibrang bhayam, but if you want to get relief, then you must have to surrender to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, as he says, and revive your old connection. Revive your... What is that old connection? That we are eternal servant of God. Don't foolishly, don't become rascal that you are one with God or equal to God, that you have become God. This is all rascal. Simply rascal. You are eternal servant of Krishna. Jiver Sarupaya Nitya. That is the teachings of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That is the beginning of teaching. Jiver Sarupaya Nitya Krishna Das. That is the beginning of knowledge, when we can understand that we are eternal. We are sons of Krishna, eternal servant of Krishna. Just like by nature is a son and servant, there is no difference. Son also gives service to the father, and the servant also gives service to the master. So there is affection either as master or servant or son and father, but it is the duty of the servant or son to give service to the Supreme. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has defined that a real sarup, sarup means original identification, not artificial. Artificial you can think, I have become God, I have become Bhagavan, I am this, I am that. You are all rascal now. The real position is that eternal servitude. That is not this servitude. We sometimes shudder, oh, I have to become servant. No, you do not know. How much happy life is that servitude? That we do not know. We compare with this because materially we are infected. We are thinking to become servant of God is like servant of... No. There in the spiritual world, the servant of God and servant is the same. Therefore, Guru is servant of Krishna, but he is accepted as Krishna. Sakshadharitena samasta shastra. This is the verdict of all shastra. Guru never says that I am Krishna, I am God, I am Bhagavan. No, he never says. He is not Guru then. He will say, I am the most humble servant of the servant of the servant of God, not direct servant. Servant, 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 100 times down. Gopi bhattu padakamalayo daso 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 dasano das. This is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's verse. Gopi bhattu padakamalayo daso 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 dasano das. The more you become servant, servant, that perfect servant. Don't try to become direct servant. That is not possible. You cannot become direct servant. You first of all become servant of the servant. The Guru is the servant of Krishna, and you become his servant, then you are bona fide servant. That is our real position. So, therefore Chaitanya Mahaprabhu offers his prayer. Oi nanda tanuja potitam king karangam. King karang means servant. He is offering prayer, my dear Lord, the son of Nanda Maharaj. Krishna accepted the son of mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj. So he is very much pleased if anyone addresses Krishna as the son of Vasudev or Vasudev. Vasudev means the son of Vasudev. And if someone addresses him, Yashodanandana, Brajajana Ranjan, he is very happy. Because when you address Krishna in relationship with pure devotee, he is very happy. Therefore he address Yashodanandana, Nandanandana, Vasudeva Nandana, Radhika Ramana. Like that. So therefore Chaitanya Mahaprabhu addresses Krishna, Ai Nanda Tanuja, O the son of Nanda Maharaj. Ai Nanda Tanuja, Patitam Kinkaranga Mama Bhishame Bhavam Budho. Now I am your eternal servant. Somewhere or other I have fallen down in this ocean of birth and death. Bhavam Budho, Bhava. Bhava means you become and again vanish. That is Bhava. And that is Ambudhi. Ambudhi means a sea. You do not know how long you are taking this business, accepting one body and again dying, again accepting, and not only here, throughout the whole universe. Many planets, many species of life, this is going on. Therefore Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, ei rupe brahmanda bhramite kono bhagavan ji guru krishna kripaye paye bhakti lata bij. In this way we are wandering one life to another, one planet to another. In this way millions of years you don't care for it, because you are not afraid. You are so proud and brave. That tibraṁ bhayam, we don't care for it. Tibraṁ bhayam. There is tibraṁ. Just after a few years, I will enter again. The tibraṁ bhayam. But you are careless. This is foolishness. This is a fool's where angels dare not, fools racing. That means we are so, therefore Krishna says, mūḍha. Namāṁ duṣkitanam mūḍha prapadyante narādhama. Those who are not Krishna conscious, not surrendering to Krishna, their categories have been explained, that sinful, duskritina. Duskritina means duskarja. Any kriti. Kriti means very meritorious. But duskriti. Merit is being misused for some nonsense activities. Therefore duskriti. There are two kinds of activities, sukriti and duskriti. Sukriti means for some good purpose, and duskriti for some bad purpose. That is called. So we are all engaged. Always engaged to engage our brain to manufacture something will be very facilitous for committing sinful activities. That is science, advancement of science. So many things, just like contraceptive. Now, advertised by the scientists. Now here is a very nice contraceptive, use it. That means people will take up the scientific advancement and entangle him in sinful activities. Yes. Duskritana. Meritorious, but it is used for sinful activities. That is called duskritana. So this class of men, those who have got merit, but it is not being used for useful purposes, for some sinful activities, they are called Duskitin. This class of man, atheist class of man, they never surrender to Krishna. Namang Duskitin na Mura. Prapadanti na Mura. They do not understand that he has to face so much trouble in birth and death and old age, and he has no knowledge how to stop it. Therefore they are Mura. Rascal. Namang Duskitin na Mura. Prapadanti na Radha. And lowest of the human mind, human brain can understand that I am suffering. But because he is not understanding, therefore he is the lowest of the humankind. Naradhama. These things are described in the Bhagavad Gita. No, they have passed MA degree, PhD, the Maya Bhuritagyana. The knowledge has no value because it is Maya. He is thinking, he is employing for temporary happiness. Maya happiness. Maya sukhaya bharamud bahato bimura. He has learnt engineering and planning, very high skyscraper. But he does not know how long he will live that skyscraper building. Say 25 years, 50 years, that's all. Maya sukhaya, temporary happiness. He is engaging his brain in so stupendous, horrible war, ugra karma. Maya sukhaya bharamud bahato bimura. Real business he has neglected. How to get out of these clutches of birth and death, and he engages his brain for manufacturing skyscraper building. And he is thinking now advancement of knowledge, advancement of education. This is going on. Therefore, if we want to save ourselves from the fearful condition of this material life, then we must take shelter of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That is the verdict of the all shastras, and Krishna comes for this purpose, and Krishna's devotees work day and night for this purpose, and that is called Krishna Consciousness Movement.